talk about the economic status of Vijayanagar Empire, and today we are going to learn about the different literatures of that period, that is the books written during that period. Sanskrit, the books were written in three languages during the period of Vijayanagar, that is in Sanskrit, Telugu and Kannada. Among the Sanskrit books, the first we can see that Shankara Vijaya was written by Vidyaranya, and Vidyaranya was the person who also wrote Sarva Darshan Sangraha. These two books were written by Vidyaranya. Then third we can see that Vedarta Prakasha and Ayurveda Sumanidhi, these were written by Sanacharya. These were the Sanskrit books were written during that period. And coming back here, we can see this, there are many poets who wrote in Kannada also. Then this Madhura Vijayam was written by Ganga Devi. Sunanidhi, a drama, was written by Prauda Devaraya. And Jambavati Kalyana, Madalasa Charitam and Rasa Manjari, these were the three which were written by Krishna Devaraya. Then coming back here, we can see that Gadukina Bharata was written by Kumara Vyasa. Bharatisha Vaibhava was written by Ratna Karavani. Then Prabhu Linga Lile was written by Chamadas. And then Shiva Tattva Chintamani was written by Dakkanna. And Basava Purana was written by Bhima. So these were the books written during the Vijayanagar Empire period by these different poets. Krishna Devaraya was also known as Andhra Bhoja, because he encouraged Telugu literature a lot, and the book written by him in Telugu was called Amukta Malyala. This was the book written by him in Telugu, and there were eight famous personalities in his kingdom known as Ashtadiggajas. A few names here given, you can see here the Ashtadiggajas, namely Allasami Pettanna, Nandi Timmanna, Srinatha, Pingali Subanna, and Tenali Ramakrishna. Here they have given five names among the eight famous scholars kept in this kingdom known as Ashtadiggajas. So this was about them. Now coming to the religious harmony that the kingdom had was, there was a lot of religious tolerance among the kings. So they encouraged all religions and saw that they all lived together. And many kings solved the differences of opinions between Jains and Vaishnavas also. And the Ottoman visitor Barbosa had stated, seeing the oneness among all there, that all religions lived happily as equal respect was given to all by the kings of that time. Coming to the art and sculptures, the temples built during that period were Virupaksha, Hazaradama Swami Temple, Vithala Swami Temple, Krishna Swami Temple, Kamala Mahal, Sringeri Vidya Shankar. These were the temples built during that period, and these were the famous places known for their art and sculpture during the Vijayanagar period were Kalahalli, Sri Shaila, Tirupati, Chidambaram, Sri Rangam, Kumbakonam and Kanchi. These were the places known for the art and sculpture of that period. There was another Lepakshi temple, which was also called as Shaikas Ajanta, had all the sketches of Shiva Purana of that period. This was about the art and sculpture. Now coming to the last part of the lesson, that is the chronological period, you can see here, you have to learn this, write it down, learn this properly in the pattern given here. This is called chronological period. That is the ruling period of Vijayanagara was from 1336 to 1565. So during that period, one by one we will see that Sangama dynasty was from 1336 to 1485. Harihara ruled from 1336 to 1357. Krishna Deva Raya belonged to the Kulwa dynasty. So his rule was from 1509 to 1529. So this is, and the last one you have to remember is the Battle of Talikota, which brought end to the Vijayan, was on 23rd January 1565. See children, so the lesson completes here. You have to, the notes will be sent to you. You have to copy down the notes in your notebooks, write it down, learn it, and be ready for the coming test or whatever is, will be given to you once you come attend the classes. So please try to see that you will copy it properly, neatly, and corrections will be done when you come back to school. Thank you.